Hello, everyone. My name is Ankush Goyal, and I'm a Senior Technical Account Manager here at AWS.
Hi, everyone. This is Jackie Yim Raybun. I'm also a Technical Account Manager at the Amazon Web Service.
In today's video, we will explore how Amazon Q Developer can help you in your operations. Let's first talk about what Amazon Q is. There are millions of people who are using Amazon AI chat applications. And what early providers have done in this space is very exciting and useful for our customers. However, these offerings are very limited in how much they can help people at work because they use very general knowledge about their customers. They don't know about the customers in detail, about their specific business use cases, about their data, about their operations, and they were not designed to meet the data privacy and security requirements. This is why AWS has built Amazon Q, AWS GenAI powered assistant that helps you to write code, answer your questions, summarize data, generate content, and solve problems. Even it can manage your AWS resources and take actions on your behalf. Amazon Q is built with security and privacy in mind from the start, which make it easier for organizations to use GenAI safely. Amazon Q has multiple areas of expertise to meet the needs of different users and roles across organizations. Amazon Q provides capability for every employee with the Amazon Q business plan. Q can connect to customers' data repository, answer their questions, and summarize the data, and can carry on that conversation and even can take actions on your behalf. Another product, Amazon Q, for developers and IT professionals are available through Amazon Q Builder Plan. It can help you to write, debug, test, and transform your code, such as moving from one old version of Java to the latest version. We also offer Amazon Q in QuickSight, which can help customers to quickly drive data insights using natural languages. And Amazon Q in Connect can also help you to remove the heavy lifting from customer support engagements. Q is transforming the way you do your work and is available wherever you are, such as it's available in AWS consoles, your favorite IDE, it's available in AWS documentation and in the mobile applications as well. It integrates with Slacks and Teams through your AWS chatbot and can easily integrate or fits with your existing workflows. Now I will hand it over to Jackie, who will talk about a few use cases and give you a quick demo on how you can use Amazon Q.
All right, today we're going to be working on the use case of the Q, how Q can help you on your day-to-day work. Our first use case we're going to be covering today is EC2 Instance Recommendation using Amazon Q. The second one, Troubleshoot Console Error with Amazon Q, and followed by the Cost Analysis in the Cost Explorer using Amazon Q. And we also will cover the troubleshooting network connectivity delay issue using Amazon Q. And last but not least, create AWS support case using Amazon Q. All right, let's dive into the first use case, use EC2 instant recommendations. So we're gonna go into the console. And so basically, we're going to go to the EC2 console. So with that, we just go to click on the launch instant. But we're not going to launch the instant. We're going to get some advice, you know, basically based on your particular use case. We're going to go to advice. So basically, you just provide a use case, that fit with your need. So in this case, I'm gonna choose data science analytics, and basically workload type, something aligned to that, right? Scientifics, simulation, numericals, computings, and priority is what you really need. You need a low cost, high performance. In this case, I want to get the result fast. So I aim for the high performance, for the CPU manufacturer, you can choose the specific type of the architecture, Intel, AMD, or Graviton, or even Apple Macs. In this case, I will put it no preference. So, and basically just get instant type advice. So basically with that use case and workload type, and you put in and priorities, it will generate the prompt for Amazon Q, and you just have to send the prompt to process. And basically it's just gonna provide you the result with the EC2 instance recommendation. So in this case, EC2 instance selection, they recommend instance family C7i, C6i, P3, F1, C7a, HPC7a, HPC6a, C6a. And basically, they also provide some reason why they recommend those type of instance. And also, they provide you some link to reference to that detail of that type of instance. All right, we'll go to the next use case. The next use case, troubleshoot console error using Amazon Q. So for this particular sample, I'm going to use the Lambda for the sample of the troubleshooting. So we have a Lambda function that I created for S3. So basically, this Lambda function is a function to write a file to S3 written in Python code. So very simple functions. So basically, just write a text, and then we basically just write this text to the S3 bucket. So I'm going to run these functions. And basically, we get the error because the executing function failed. So we have some error details. So you see the button show diagnostic with Amazon Q. You can click this button. And so basically, Q will provide some detail that this error indicated Lambda function does not have necessary permissions to write the object to the S3 bucket. So basically, you can click this to get further assistance, help me resolve this issue. So with that, Q will provide you some step to fix the issue. So this depends on the nature of the issue. This could take a few minutes before it come back. All right, so basically Q recommend to follow this step to resolve the error. So if you don't have a permissions, go to the AM, basically looking at the role. So just to make sure that the role have a permissions to for you to write into the S3 bucket. So in this case, yeah, we can try to see if we can resolve this issue. So we go to configurations, look at the permission. So we notice that we only, for this particular one, let's click on the edits. So we only have a permission to write to car watchdog. So with this, I already created a role that have a permission. Just want to show you, we can fix it by give it the right permissions to be able to write to S3. So I changed to the role that have access to write a file to S3. After that, we can just go back and rerun the test. All right, screen. So now simply have permission. So now we successfully write the text to the S3 bucket. All right, we'll go to the next use case. So recently, Q just launched the new functionality. So basically, you can eventually get some cost analysis from Cost Explorer. So let me give you some sample of this. So let's ask Q, what were the top three highest cost service in Q4 2023? So basically, instead of you going to Cost Explorer and have to, you know, click all those, you can use the natural language and ask that. And basically, the top three highest cost of AWS service in Q4 2023 were RDS, and then followed by the Redshift and Cost Whisperer. And it gives you a detail of that when you mentioned Q4 date range, it starts from October 2023 to December 31st, 2023. Let's do another sample. Let's see, what was total spending in Q1? So in this case, if you don't put in the year, basically it will just assume it's the current year, which is 2024. So total AWS spending in Q1 was $775.78. All right, that's another use case. Troubleshoot network connectivity is related issue using Amazon Q. So for this particular one, you can simply just type in, you know, if you have issue, try to, you know, get to the EC2 instance, you can basically just ask you, you know, why can't I secure shell to EC2 instance? So basically, you know, look like you need help with the network connectivity issue. You know, so Q is basically integrate with the tools called VPC reachability analyzer to provide you interactive troubleshootings. So basically you just click the link here. Currently it's still in preview mode and it's only available in the US East one. For this demo, we won't dive into the detail, but we will provide you the link and QR code for the YouTube video that deep dive into this particular VPC reachability analyzer tools. All right, so in this case, we assume that, you know, that tools, after using that tool, you still cannot fix the issue and you need to talk to the support. Normally, we're gonna just have to open the case with support, but with Q, you can just say, we need to talk to support. So Q will use the context of your conversation. You can basically ask many questions regarding to troubleshooting. Q will summarize it and basically draft the case for you. So as you see, Q already put in the case for you. Customer was unable to secure shell to the EC2 instance. So you already tried the VPC tools and it doesn't fix the issue. So now you need to open the case. It already grabbed the case ready for you, already put in technical type. So you just have to choose the service. In this case, you're using Linux, you just put in Linux, and then the default is the severity general guidance. But if this is urgent or critical, you can set the severity to be aligned with your need. This is critical if this is a production outage. And then basically you just hit the submit. You can attach the file to this and then it will automatically generate a case, support case for you. Okay, that's will be the last use case for today.